friends, to our show Saral Baat. Friends, today we are going to talk about vaccination. What is vaccination? How it helps in our body? How it works in our body? Is there any side effects of vaccination? Whether it has to be taken again and again and so on. So to talk on this particular topic, we have an expert with us, Dr. Kirti. Dr. Kirti is a practitioner, medical practitioner, MD. She is super specialist in infectious diseases. Let's meet Dr. Kirti and talk on vaccination. Dr. Kirti, welcome.
Hello.
Welcome to our show, Saral Baat. Dr. Kirti, first of all, I would like to know that what is vaccination and how it works in our body?
Today's topic is actually not a very common topic which is discussed.
Right.
So vaccination, normally our concept is only for kids. Vaccinations are not only for kids. They're also for adults. So today's actually topic is adult vaccination.
Right.
How elderly people or age people above 18 needs vaccination and how it is helping them to have a better life.
Right.
So vaccinations are nothing but we give a small amount of antigen. Antigen is a thing which causes infection. We put them in the body, which is in an inactive form. So it will not cause actual disease, but it will cause an immunity generation, which will prevent if you are getting exposed to that vaccine, if you're getting exposed to that particular disease, your body will fight better. Your body will try to eliminate that particular infection earlier. So vaccines are not available for everything. They are available for certain pathogens, majority of viruses and bacteria.
So do vaccines really protect the body against the disease?
Yeah, this is a very commonly asked question. People think that vaccines are just, doctor wants to give something to us, so they are offering vaccination. It's not like that. There are scientific studies, and before giving any vaccine to people, there are various studies done regarding how it will work, how it will cause side effects, what can be the side effects. So normally vaccines work. Nothing works 100%, everybody knows. So vaccines, if they're not working 100%, at least they will reduce the severity of the illness. For example, flu vaccine. There is a flu vaccine which is available every year. It changes. Every year we are supposed to take. It helps in reducing the episode. Suppose you're getting, few people have a tendency to get recurrent sneezing, coughing, flu. In at least 5 to 6 times in a year. So if you take that vaccine, at least it will reduce the episodes to 1 or 2. And if the episodes are very severe, like a few people who are having asthma, few people who are having lung diseases, few people who have underwent transplant, these people immunity is little lower than what other people will have. So these people, if they get any illness, like a normal common cold, sneezing, coughing, they get it for long time. They are ill for 8 to 10 days. They can't go to the work. They have to get admitted. So this severity of the illness will be reduced if you take vaccines.
Okay, what are the cost of vaccines as such?
So normally, what happens, the vaccines in India are when they are given for kids, they are generally given funded by government. But for adult vaccination as such, there's no funding by government. The patient has to pay from their pocket. So depends upon which vaccine is recommended by your physician, by your infectious disease consultant. The cost of vaccination will vary something between 1,000 for a particular vaccine to up to like 4,000 for particular vaccines. But the vaccines which are costlier, like up to a range of 4,000, 5,000, they're not vaccines you take every year. They are okay. Life, once in lifetime. So I think it's a good investment. When if you go to a mall, we spend like 2,000 to 3,000 rupees. So you're spending something which is on your health, which is for lifetime. I think okay. It will be
a few diseases benefit. Can you mention for which vaccination for adults is available?
Yeah. So the commonly, which we have a vaccination clinic as an infectious disease consultant, we practice vaccination quite routinely. So I will recommend vaccines for people who are definitely people who are more than 60. People who have diabetes, people who have lung problems like asthma, COPD, people who have underwent transplant, let it be a lung transplant, liver transplant, heart transplant, people who are having cancer, who are on a heavy chemotherapy, people who are having arthritis, who are going and seeing rheumatologist, who are taking immunosuppression for their arthritis problem. All these category of people definitely need to have vaccinations. They can check with their regular physician, they can check with their primary doctor like a nephrologist, if they are having a kidney transplant, like a rheumatologist, and take these vaccines. So
which vaccines exactly?
Vaccines are hepatitis B.
Okay.
Pneumonia vaccines. There are two vaccines for pneumonia. There is one vaccine for flu and one vaccine for chickenpox. So these four vaccines I will recommend.
Talking about vaccinations, I would like to know one thing, that is there any side effects of these vaccinations?
Yeah, that's a very good question, because normal medicines also cause side effects, and this we are giving a small part of actually the antigen which is causing you an infection. So vaccines, the side effects can be of two types. It can be mild side effects which will happen to most of the people but are easily treatable. I'll tell those first. These are like kids get vaccines, they have fever, they have pain at where the vaccine is given. These are the two common side effects: mild fever for 1 or 2 days, pain at the site of injection for 1 or 2 days. Other than that, there are no major side effects of vaccination. These are the common side effects, and which will be tackled by giving just ice fomentation or paracetamol like medicines, which are tablets.
Okay.
Major side effects are very, very rare, because those gets highlighted more, but they are not common. In last my 15 years of practice, none of my patients have serious side effects because of vaccination. Serious side effects can be like few people can develop allergic reaction immediately.
Okay.
Like breathing difficulty, BP down, they can have convulsions, but these are very, very rare. 1 in 1 million people might get it. These can be serious side effects, but before giving them, we don't know who is going to develop. That's also one thing, but hardly, because it's been tested quite well, it's very rare side effects, once in a million.
So it is very safe.
It's very, very safe to take, and mm-hmm. it is, we have what is something called as risk versus benefit. Having 1 in 1 million side effect, you can't avoid the benefits which the vaccine is going to give when you really require it. Like
okay.
the people are getting saved from having pneumonia. Pneumonia can, in people who are having low immunity, can be life-threatening. People who are elderly, people above 65, pneumonia can be life-threatening. People can die because of pneumonia. So in
okay.
those patients, these vaccines are life-saving.
I think so, even above 40 who are diabetic or
yeah.
who are having BP problems or any other
we
infectious
for them.
Problem, they, it can be dangerous
yeah.
for them
yeah.
also.
Yeah.
Okay, I want to know whether the vaccines once given, is there any need to give again and again?
Not all vaccines, as I said, need to give again and again. Only flu vaccine, because flu is a virus which changes its shape very rapidly.
Okay.
We have to give it every year, because immunity protection is only for a year.
Okay.
Other vaccines like pneumonia, hepatitis B, chickenpox, we don't need to give it again and again. Only pneumonia, one vaccine we give it once in 5 years.
Okay.
That also above 65. Hepatitis B is life. This is a course of 3 vaccines. Once you give the 3 courses, we don't need to repeat it. Unless you are a dialysis patient. For dialysis patient, we do need to repeat, because the immunity tends to come down with,
okay.
as you go many dialysis. Again, the chickenpox vaccine, we don't need to repeat. These are the another vaccines, few which are recommended are typhoid vaccines and hepatitis A vaccine. So both of these, we don't need to repeat them again.
Okay. So nice of you, doctor. You gave really very nice information on vaccination. I am sure many of us must not be aware about vaccinations be in adults, and you really helped us with such a wonderful information. Friends, if you want us to talk on some other topic, you can mention in our comment box, or you can mail us. The mail address has been mentioned. We will be meeting Dr. Kirti once again, and we'll be talking about urinary tract infections. So keep in touch and keep watching my channel. See you soon. Bye.